This is the work of Gene Barry in our November 2017 show called The Way In. So, hi, Gene.
Hi, Chris. this work is my most recent work. It's my fiber work, and it deals with Army blankets. I've collected and mended them for years and was in an anti-war show a couple of years ago, and I thought, oh, I've got all these mended Army blanket pieces, so I started making scrolls. And I had other parts of quilts, crazy quilts, that I wanted to save. And so even though they were kind of tattered, I mended. A couple of years, maybe 4 years now, I was in a show, or I was at the Toronto Museum, Royal Museum, and I saw it was a garment show, and they had these wonderful Muslim ecclesiastical garments. And they were like white hop sacking material, and then row after row of chain stitching. That in the statement, each stitch a meditation, each stitch a prayer, and I thought, I can use that with what I've been working on. So I love the chain stitch because it's like a line, it's like a drawing line. It also it keeps two surfaces together, and it also mends. So it was another way to increase my mending practice. This piece is a scroll, and I've done a series of scrolls. They're fun for me to do, and they hang down. Again, they're very linear. And I use pieces. In this piece in particular, I have the targets that I put on the side. Targets to me are significant because they're more intuitive, spiritual. They're based on my studies of bird's nest that I did years ago and continue with. And so that's what they are. I made the nest when I made the. If for this particular piece, I went to New York and it was a long plane trip and I was in the hotel for a while because of the weather. So I just kept sewing. And that's what all of those are from. Young Street, that's the street I grew up in Hastings, Michigan. I grew up on a farm, and that's where a lot of the Army blankets started. We used them when we were kids. We had them in the barn. We had them on camping trips. We had them all over. My dad brought them home from World War II. He was a pilot. He flew B-26 planes. And when I was in the anti-war show, I didn't realize that he had to fly through flak. And he had talked about how he would have to fly wing to wing and couldn't break formation. But I never realized that that meant you had to go through this incoming flak that was really dangerous. So I had a lot of nerve. So he came home and he brought the Army blankets. And in all of these pieces, there is an Army blanket that is from France, from him. This piece has got a shirt quilt that Teresa Peterson and I found on the streets of Detroit, and very clearly hand done. I'm guessing that it's from the 30s, and it was falling apart. And again, I wanted to incorporate. And this piece I started part by part, and began to put things together in this area. Here I had a whole another section, and I had to take it out because it just didn't work right. When I initially did this, and I had it in showing, look down here, and you can still see there was really a lot of moth holes. So I took it off, and I had to remend part of the pieces. So anywhere you see, like these felt pieces, those are mending. Those are pieces that are mended. Hmm. This was the first piece I did. This is called Seep. And I just started doing this crazy chain stitching, and it needed something. When all of these I do an over dye. After they're done, I come home and I dye with a tea dye or something. But I brought it to my studio and I thought, oh, it's not right, it needs something more. And so I added the black underneath, and I thought that was a nice addition. I, again, added a whole lot on the top, and I ended up taking it out. And I'm redoing. That was the first piece I did using the chain stitch and the Army blankets.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, Jean.
Well, thank you.